Well, tonight, people all across New Hampshire are remembering the life of one of the state's greatest public servants. Warren Rudman lost his battle with cancer last night at the age of 82 with his family by his side. In the Senate or as Attorney General, Rudman served New Hampshire for nearly 20 years. Before that, his country as a decorated Korean War veteran. Josh McElvin has a look back and reflection from those who knew him well.
Because it's their personal judgment as to whether you will rise or fall.
A shrinking violet, Warren Rudman was not.
Public agencies must use great caution in order to maintain the integrity of the law.
Whether it was his time as New Hampshire's Attorney General back in the 70s, or if it was Senator Rudman grilling Oliver North over the Iran-Contra scandal in 87, he was not one to mince words.
He did not want him to testify in private session. Under oath, he will.
Nobody typified New Hampshire's rugged independence, I think, better than Warren Rudman did in his day.
Rich Ashew was young staffer for Rudman during his second term in the Senate, and he says one of the qualities that drew people toward Rudman so much was a staunch conviction in his beliefs and his work.
And that gave him this, definitely the certain iron will to get things done, but without compromising an ounce of his principle.
Well, Mr. Coker,
another longtime friend, our own Fred Coker, would go on to join Rudman for 12 years in Washington, working with him on perhaps his signature piece of legislation.
Graham Rudman Hollings' deficit reduction law in the 1980s, if that had been left on the books by Congress, we wouldn't have the fiscal cliff right now.
Even after leaving the Senate in 1993, the Republican Rudman's ability to reach across the aisle was exemplified with an offer from then-President Clinton to be his Treasury Secretary. Rudman would decline the offer, but stayed busy in politics and public service, at one point joining with Gary Hart to author a report warning of the threat of terrorism.
The rubber meets the road for the people of Manchester, New Hampshire, if a weapon of mass destruction happens in Boston.
9/11 would happen later that same year.
He was really ahead of his time on all those issues and was a leader in the Congress in working across the aisle and maybe one of the last of the generation of senators that did that.
It's the type of leadership many believe this country is thirsting for today, and that's why if New Hampshire had a political Mount Rushmore, Warren Rudman would almost certainly have a place on it. Josh McElvin, WMUR News 9.
And this afternoon, President Obama released a statement on Rudman's passing, calling him one of the country's great public servants, saying leaders on both sides of the aisle would be well served to follow Warren Rudman's example of common sense, bipartisan.